Hi, I'm Tom Miller and welcome to The Asshole Chef. Today we're fucking with lobsters, and lobsters are expensive and fancy, hence the hat. There are several different ways to relatively humanely dispatch of a lobster. Into the freezer you go, John. 2 hours later, John is dead. Two is to throw it in boiling water head first. 10 seconds, dead. What the fuck was so difficult about that? The third, oddly enough, is the most humane way to dispatch a lobster, but it looks so brutal and painful. And yet, when you drive that knife into their little whatever they think with, they're gone instantaneously. And let me tell you something about the lobster brain. They make crickets look like geniuses. Now, because I love and respect lobsters so much, I'm going to cut the bands off of this lobster's pinchy pinchers and give them a fair shot at me. I think that's important to do. Food comes with risk. And I'll tell you something, you know, when people eat food, something's got to die. Now, these vegetarian people, I respect what they eat, but let's be honest. They will rip the heads right off of a lettuce and not even give it the common courtesy of killing it before they put it into their maws. Some other vegans, you know what they do. They rip the hearts right out of romaine lettuce or artichokes. At least I have the common decency to kill my food before I eat it. If you put them in the freezer for 5 minutes, they'll kind of numb out. It's sort of like, well, we in the kitchen industry call it anesthetic. The other thing you can do then is to hypnotize the lobster. This is a unique technique that only I, the asshole chef, and a few other badass chefs use. Lobster hypnosis. Watch carefully. Take your knife. The ass back of your knife, not the sharp edge, faces the ass of the lobster. Ass to ass. Ass, ass. And what you do is you glint the light at the lobster and get its attention. Then you very, very carefully draw the knife right between its little eyes like this. Glinting, glinting. Make him a little nervous. He's looking, and then he's hypnotized. He's not moving anymore. Lobster's hypnotized, and while he is hypnotized, you'll notice that across his back is a cross. Get it? Across his back, cross. Across his back is a cross. That is your target. And what you simply do while the lobster is hypnotized is place your knife very carefully into that cross, like so, and slam it down with your fists. Fernando is now dead. That's how you humanely kill a lobster, with lobster hypnosis. One cup of basmati rice. What you want to do is wash the starch off of this rice. Give it a rinse in cold water, stick it in a pan. Don't worry about that. That's just foaming lobster. One part rice to 1.5 parts water, hence cup and a half. Western measurements that we do in the United States of America. In like Flynn. Next, we are going to make fragrance in the rice. A little bit of cardamom, very difficult to say, cardamom. Just a little, not a lot, only a little. Cardamom, then star anise. Star anise. One star anise into the rice. Turn the heat on almost high. Boil, boil. Let it boil. When it's done boiling, cover. What you do is you bring the knife down through the head, like this. So there's Fernando. Next, we take off the claws. The tail pulls up, twist, stomach sac out. Hey, all right. And what you want to do is remove the gray poupon mustard. This is a pretty clean lobster, so we're good to go. We want to make these claws easy to get into. Here's the way to do it. Cover it up with a piece of cloth. Take the back of your knife like so. And now those claws are happening. All right, let's saute this baby up in the preparation I like to call the asshole chef sautés a lobster in brandy, wine, butter, garlic, and herbs served over perfectly infused jasmine rice. Let's get to work. You want to get your pan really hot. Feels kind of hot to me. Little olive oil, butter. The olive oil helps the butter to lower its burn temperature. When you get that moving, immediately, here's a clove of garlic. I'm going to show you the karate way to open it up. Then put that in there, and then we're going to add some herbs, and these herbs happen to be chopped parsley, sage, and that long thing that is like an onion. Then you throw these in there. Chives, that's what I meant to say. Throw your claws in there. Claws take the longest to cook. All right, so the claws are sautéing. We'll lower the heat a little because we don't want to burn anything. Claws are sautéing. Then tail meat. Tail meat. Tail meat. Tail meat. Tail meat. And then throw his face in there just so he's looking at you while you're cooking. He deserves that kind of respect. So keep that going. We got a nice temperature going. We are sautéing lobster. All right. Turn everything over. You want to get both sides happening here. Nice and easy. Everything gets cooked. Do not overcook the lobster. That's the main point. Get it? Main? Main lobster? Get it? That's one of my asshole chef jokes. Did you get it? You got it. Main lobster. That's the main point. Don't overcook your lobster. This whole dish is done in under 10 minutes. Maybe 10 minutes. That's it. Okay, here we go. Squeeze lemon. Squeeze lemon. Squeeze lemon. Lemon's great with lobster. Lemons love lobsters, and lobsters love lemons. It's the way to go. All right, we're going to turn the heat up a little, because now we're going to get serious, my man. That's right, Fernando. You're going to be delicious. Flip it over again. The steam rising up helps to cook this. Flip it over again. You want all that delicious flavor in there. We're going to add a little bit of salt. I like to put it in my hand first so I don't accidentally put too much. A little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. That I like to just do. Who cares? Who gives a shit? That's my catchphrase. And now we're going to take some brandy of your choice, a high quality brandy, and we're going to Flambé! Oh, it's getting out of control. Oh boy. Just kidding. That's what we want. Lots of fire. Lots of fire. Then, a nice dry white wine. Something you would drink when you're driving your friend's car. Put the wine in and deglaze, there we go, deglaze. And now my favorite part of the dish, ladies and gentlemen, as we turn it over, make sure the lobster is thoroughly, thoroughly cooked, as this wine is reducing into the most delicious sauce you've ever put in your mouth since sex. What we want to do now is shit ton of Irish butter. Shit ton of Irish butter. Butter, 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 butter. Lemon's the key. Reduce the sauce, reduce the sauce. I'm going to turn the lobster one more time, and then I'm thinking this lobster is cooked right where it needs to be. Move those pieces, tail pieces. This is Maine lobster, USA. See how that's starting to thicken up? See how rich and delicious that butter sauce is becoming? All right. And now here's the deal. As this is reducing, we are going to plate this up around that basmati rice I showed you how to make, and then you are going to be in for a treat. And lay this out over the rice, around the rice. Put his face here so he can look at you while you're eating him. That's a good thing to do. Okay, lots of good meat in these little parts. Here's another claw there. Another piece of its butt, the tasty part. Lobster butt, everybody loves it. And then, once that's there, we're gonna drizzle this sauce around the outside of the dish like so. Oh my word. All right, maybe put some of these little bits and pieces over the top of the rice. And then, for God's sakes, garnish your dishes. Make them look attractive. Would a piece of parsley kill you? And then drizzle a little olive oil over the top like so. And then what we're dealing with is a serious, serious lobster dish that anyone can make and enjoy. What the fuck is so difficult about that? Actually, it's a very difficult recipe. I don't recommend it. Okay, the lobsters are done cooking. The buzzer has gone off. They are a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful red color. And we are going to put them in a vessel so that they can sit there and cool. Okay, fingerling potatoes, little delicate, delicious balls of potato love in boiling water with a little salt. Boiling water. It's not boiling yet because you put it in cold water first, but then it boils. Put them in cold water first, bring it to the boil, and when it becomes fork tender, done. I'm going to take a strong drink of Drandy because you would not believe how many chefs fuck up aioli. It's so simple to make, and yet people can't seem to wrap their heads around it. And if you drink a shot of brandy and you go with your gut instinct, aioli is as easy as apple pie. Let's make some aioli. Egg yolks, 2. Go in food processor. Then, mustard. Put mustard in, 1 teaspoonful. Use a teaspoon and put a teaspoonful, 1 teaspoon, that's 1 teaspoon, fingerling potatoes. Then, turn on food processor. Before turning on food processor, put in food processor blade. Very important in the making of aioli. You don't want to mess this up. You really need to probably use the blade. Then turn food processor on. In slowly. Add olive oil, and I mean slowly, or you'll get a thin watery mixture that you'll have to throw down the sink like I did in the edit. Olive oil, slow. Slow olive oil in there. Slow, go, slow. Then, sunflower oil. Not too fast. Make it with your heart and your guts. Don't read a recipe or you'll fuck it up. Slow, go, not much mo, thickening up for show, that's the way the money goes, pop goes the weasel. Then, lemon, squeeze, no seeds please, pepper to taste, well that tastes pretty good, salt to taste. By God, you are an asshole chef that can salt something just right. Pulse. Wait. A little cold water. Cold water. Very difficult to make aioli. Most people fuck this up.
Pulsing. 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 Yeah!
Get a spoon and taste. Always taste. Why would you serve something that you didn't taste that might end up tasting like shit? It's your fault then, isn't it? Oh my God, that is heaven. That is heaven. Needs a little more salt, then herbs. Herbs we chopped in there. Put it into your A-E-I-O-L-E-A-O-L-E. Stand! That's not working. Be safe. Don't ever run it without the top on. You could cut your fingers more than once. There. Put it in the refrigerator. That's how you make aioli. Turn the fucking camera off. I'm irritated. All right, we've got our chilled cooked lobster. This was Bob. Now it's just food. And what we're going to do is we're going to butcher this little fella in a very rather, you know, a sophisticated way. What you do is you take the claw, twist it back, and it pops right off because it's perfectly cooked. Then you take this claw, twist it back, pops right off because it's perfectly cooked. Then you take the tail and you bend it in the way it was never intended to go until it pops out like so. Oh, that's a beautiful sound. And then you twist, and that's that delicious tail meat right there. There's also a lot of good stuff happening in the body cavity, depending on whether or not Bob is a boy or a girl. All right. Well, here's Bob's internal situation. And as you can see, we have the tamale, the liver. We have the stomach sac behind the eye there. Oh my, Bob's a, Bob's a lady. Bob's got roe. That's fantastic. Roe is very, very delicious. We'll probably incorporate the roe into the aioli. Here's our plate. Here's what we do. Take a couple of beautiful, beautiful salad leaves. Your choice. Your choice. Whatever you like to do. All right? Then we take our peeled cucumber. Little places, little nests, you know. This is up to you. This is when you get creative. You have a lot of fun here. It's all part of the salad, you know what I mean? Little places like that. See, isn't that nice? Okay. Then what we do is we take maybe some salad greens, which we cut here down at the bottom, like this. Isn't that nice? Yeah. Yeah, that's nice, isn't it? And then we take one of the claws there, Bob's claw. This is Bob's other claw going that way. See? And then we take Bob's tail right in the middle like that. Isn't that pretty? Yeah. And then we take Bob's upper body and put him like that. Okay, people can get into the roe if they want. You know, scoop out the stomach, And then, you know, scoop out like the stomach sac here behind the eye, if you can get that out of there. And then we take the aioli. Remember our aioli? And we spoon the aioli into the crevices of Bob's upper body. Like so. See? Aioli. Like that. Aioli. Fill that up there. You can make your aioli thicker. I kind of like it as more of like a sauce like that. Yeah. Maybe put a little bit around there. A little bit around there. And then last but not least, make sure to decorate your salad with those fingerling potatoes. Just keep it rustic. Cut them in half. Put them in cool little places. take those eggs, those boiled eggs we made, cut them in half, you know, just cut them in half, that's all. Try to make it really, really cool looking. This is your salad, this is your lobster salad, man. If look, here's the deal. This shit is awesome. And then when you're done perfectly placing your eggs, your potatoes, just make it the way you want with your own artistic style, then you too can be a big asshole chef like me. There was something in the air that night. The stars were bright, Fernando. They were shining there for you and me, for liberty, Fernando. Though we never thought that we could lose, there's no regret.